And with that, we welcome in former Ram, Jaguar, Jet, Bill, and 49er Legay Doosable. Legay, did I get them all, Deuce?
I think you got them all, man. I don't think you left any off the list.
I got them all. All right, Deuce, obviously, the story has been about Aaron Rodgers this week, but Jordan Love, he gets a chance now to show what he's got. 2020 first round pick. You know, what are you looking for in this game from him specifically?
Yeah, first and foremost, I would like to talk about the Chiefs and how they just keep getting blessed, right? If you look at last week when they played the Giants, the offense was decimated. The offensive line, three of their five starters is on IR. Saquon Barkley's not playing. Kenny Galladay's not playing. Then the offensive playmakers that did play were injured, and they squeaked out a win only because the Giants were undisciplined at pivotal points in that game. But I'm excited for this game. We get to see Jordan Love, the guy that GM Brian Gutekunst traded up for, the guy that Matt LaFleur traded up for. We get to see what he's all about. Now, we saw him a little bit in the preseason before he got hurt, and he did really get well in that game versus Buffalo. They got him on the edge with some bootlegs, a lot of play action pass, some RPOs, things that he does well. And I believe that Matt LaFleur will do that this week versus the Kansas City Chiefs. Matt LaFleur had a great game plan last week versus the Arizona Cardinals. Didn't have his top three receivers in the game. So what did they do? They ran the ball effectively with A.J. Dillon, Aaron Jones, and then Aaron Rodgers was just surgical with the ball, throwing it on the underneath routes. I believe he'll do some of that this week, but I also think he'll let, you know, Jordan Love cook a little bit. I think he's comfortable with getting him on the edge with those bootlegs, some of those RPOs, and then he'll take some shots down the field. But I'm just excited to see what Jordan Love is all about, because this is the guy, and this is the reason that Aaron Rodgers was kind of sour with the Green Bay Packers, because they traded up to get this guy, Jordan Love. So we get to see what he's all about this Sunday versus the Kansas City Chiefs.
Yeah, and dudes, you know, you talk about last week for the Packers with Aaron Rodgers being surgical. That was against the Cardinals, handed the Cardinals their first loss of the season. Cardinals now go on the road to play San Francisco. And, you know, Kyler Murray, I mean, he had two picks. He had a killer pick at the end there. And this is a team that I think, you know, a lot of people think is good, but not sure quite how good. Not sure if the record is really as good as this team is. How do you look at it? How do you look at this week against San Francisco and overall what the Cardinals are right now?
Well, Gibbs, when the Cardinals went 3-0, and I was asked this question on this show, are they the real deal? To me, I was like, I'm not a believer, because we saw this from the Cardinals last year. They went 6-3, and then it all fell apart. But then when they beat the Los Angeles Rams, I recanted that, and I was like, no, the Cardinals are for real. Kyler Murray is the MVP front runner. But the issues that they had last year are starting to creep up this year. The injury bug. We saw Kyler Murray. He has the ankle injury. Will he go this Sunday? And then DeAndre Hopkins with the hamstring injury. A.J. Green on COVID protocol. But the thing is, on their defense, right, this defense gets after the passer, but they struggle stopping the run game. And with the injury to J.J. Watt, they just not played well against the run. They gave up over 120 yards on the ground. And adversely, the San Francisco 49ers, they average over 120 on the ground. So something has to give. Ultimately, I believe this team will bounce back. They'll be a good team, and they'll be a playoff team. But I don't believe that they're going to win the division. I believe the Rams will win this division.
All right, well, you talk about that Rams team, and I think the moment where everybody was like, maybe the Cardinals are for real was that Week 4 game against the Rams. They won 37-20. This is obviously now a very different Rams team with the addition of Von Miller. Overall, as you look at the NFC, how would you rank these teams? How would you stack the top five?
Yeah, this is my top five, and if you don't agree with it, I don't care. This is my top five.
Dude,
so
come
number
on,
five,
man.
This number five, I got the Tampa Bay Buccaneers, and now I know they just lost to the Trevor Siemian-led New Orleans Saints, but this is still a dangerous team. Anytime you have Tom Terrific at quarterback, you're always in the game. They proved last year that they don't have to have the number one seed. They can go on the road and win, and that secondary has been beat up. They're supposed to be getting some help back. Some guys are supposed to be getting healthy. So I ultimately believe the Tampa Bay Buccaneers will be fine. Yes, Antonio Brown and Gronkowski are hurt, but they'll get healthy as the season goes on, and this team will make a run in November and December. Number four, I got the Arizona Cardinals, and to me, Kyler Murray is the MVP frontrunner, but we just discussed them, Gabs. The injury bug is starting to scare me, because this is what happened to this team last year. They were 6-3 and fell apart towards the end of the year. At number three, I'm going with the Green Bay Packers, winners of seven straight games. Last week proved they didn't need their top three receivers to win a tough, hard-fought game. Matt LaFleur calls a great game plan. And then this is the team that's going to get the most help back If you talk about David Bakhtiari, one of the best left tackles in football, potentially coming back. Jair Alexander, their all-pro corner, is coming back. And there's a Darius Smith, their outside linebacker, is coming back. So they're going to get a lot of help, and they'll make a run in the playoffs. They've been to the NFC Championship twice. Can they get over the hump? Number two, the Dallas Cowboys. This is the most balanced offense in the NFL. Between the two running backs, Tony Pollard, Ezekiel Elliott can run the ball effectively. We know what Dak Prescott can do, throwing the ball to those two beasts on the outside, CeeDee Lamb and Amari Cooper. But this defense, man, they fly around and they get after you. You see Randy Gregory finally taking the steps the Dallas Cowboys drafted them to do. Michael Parsons is up for Defensive Player of the Year, not just Rookie Defensive Player of the Year, Defensive Player of the Year. This guy can play on the edge. He can play in the middle linebacker position. And Trayvon Diggs, if you throw the ball near him, it's getting picked off and going the other way. So the Dallas Cowboys are playing really good. The only loss was to the Tampa Bay Bucks the opening week. And then my number one team, and we just talked about it, Gels, it has to be the LA Rams. When you add the acquisition of Von Miller, him and Aaron Donald combined, they equal 200 sacks. Like, I don't know if any other team could have said that in history. And then a guy they're not really talking about, Leonard Floyd on the outside. This is a guy that leads this team in sacks, was a good acquisition for them last year, playing at a high level. Jalen Ramsey, we know, is the all-pro corner, but they line him up all over the place and line him up at nickelback, outside at corner, sometime at safety. But then on that offense, Sean McVay gets the quarterback that he always wanted in Matthew Stafford. They're able to throw the ball down the field. They run the ball, play action pass, and take shots down the field. Cooper Kupp leads the league in receiving yards. To me, the NFC Championship is going to go through the LA Rams this year.
You know, I wanted to sit here and say, I don't agree with you. I don't agree with you at all because, you know, of how you started that segment. But I can't argue with you. I cannot argue
with you.
Pretty
good list, right, guys?
Yeah, it's a pretty good list. I can't argue with you. All right, let's get a look at one more game. Patriots, Carolina. You know, the Patriots are surging here. They've won 3 of 4. The one loss was to Dallas in overtime. Nice. Yeah, the Panthers won last week, but they've certainly been going in the opposite direction. How do you look at this game? And really, what have you seen out of the Patriots here as they've started to build this momentum?
Yeah, the Patriots, to me, their contenders are not AFC contenders, but if you talk about them getting in the playoffs at the sixth or seventh seed, I can see that Mac Jones has been efficient with the ball. We know he doesn't throw the ball down the field, but all the underneath routes, all the checkdowns, he's super efficient with the ball. Now, they've opened the offense up for him a little bit, and he's taking some shots with Nelson Aguilar down the field a little bit. So he's getting more grasp and getting more used to being in control of that offense. But this team is based off the running game and the defense, and it usually has been, besides when, you know, Tom Brady was leading them to victories. But they run the football effectively with Harris in the backfield, and then on defense, they get takeaways. And Bill Belichick, that is his mantra. He's a defensive-minded coach. We saw it last week, Adrian Phillips getting a pick six that really swung the game in their favor. So this is a team that has the potential to sneak into the playoffs as a sixth or seventh seed. But I don't think they're AFC contenders if you're talking about knocking off, you know, the Buffalo Bills or the Tennessee Titans before Derrick Henry got hurt, or the Baltimore Ravens. But I do believe this is a team that can sneak in the playoffs, and it's because Mac Jones takes care of the ball, and he is efficient with the football.
Legay Doosable, my guy, Doos, great stuff as always, man. Appreciate it.
Do you want a sports network that delivers everything that matters about the game? The highlights, the picks, the instant analysis. No yelling, no fake debates, no politics. Hit the subscribe button and never miss a moment.